Can I just grab it? Good evening and welcome to our candidates forum for Sonoma Valley School District Trustees. I'm Susie Radillo, a parent of high school students and a member of the Latino Parent Coalition. Our forum today will be in Spanish and English. Please bear with us.
Muy buenas tardes y bienvenidos a nuestro foro de candidatos para la mesa directiva del Distrito Escolar del Valle de Sonoma. Soy Susy Radillo, miembro de la Coalición de Padres Latinos y madre de estudiante en la preparatoria. Nuestro foro hoy será en español e inglés, por lo tanto le pedimos su colaboración y paciencia. And my name is Mary Carmen Reyes and I will be tonight's interpreter. Mi nombre es Mary Carmen Reyes y seré la intérprete de esta noche.
The issues facing parents and students are very important to the Latino Parent Coalition. We care about elections because they have an impact on our family's life.
Los asuntos que los padres y estudiantes están enfrentando son muy importantes para la coalición de padres latinos. Nos importan las elecciones porque tendrán impacto en la vida de nuestras familias.
This forum is also sponsored by the Sonoma Housing Group, which advocates for affordable housing for our families.
Este foro de hoy está patrocinado por el Grupo de Vivienda de Sonoma, quien aboga por vivienda asequible para nuestras familias.
A few announcements before we begin. Please turn off your cell phones. Bathrooms are on the back. Child care is outside through the back door, please.
Algunos anuncios antes de empezar. Favor de apagar sus celulares. Los baños están en la parte de atrás. Y cuidado de niño está en la parte de afuera.
At the conclusion of the forum, you are invited to stay to talk with the candidates and visit the information tables.
Al final del foro se les invita a que se queden y platiquen con los candidatos y visiten las mesas de información.
Please hold your applause.
Favor de guardar los aplausos hasta final del foro.
We are very pleased that the candidates for Sonoma Valley School Board are here this evening. Please stand briefly as I introduce you.
Estamos muy agradecidos de que los candidatos para la mesa directiva del distrito escolar están aquí esta tarde. Favor de ponerse de pie brevemente para que se presenten.
Kathy Coleman. Thank you. And Omar Paz. Melanie Blake is the only candidate from the Flowery School area, so she will automatically become a trustee. Thank you, Melanie, for coming tonight to share your ideas with the community.
Melanie Blake es la única candidata del área de Flowery, así que automáticamente será miembro de la mesa directiva. Gracias, Melanie, por venir a compartir con nosotros esta noche.
Trustees are elected for four years. Each Sonoma Valley School trustee must live in a different school attendance area, but registered voters from all school areas choose the trustees. Trustees then represent residents from all areas of the district. Current trustees from Alvarado and Flowery areas are now running for re-election.
Los miembros son electos por 4 años. Cada candidato deberá vivir en el área que representará. Pero votantes de todas las escuelas tienen la oportunidad de votar por ellas. Por lo tanto, miembros representan a residentes de áreas de todo el distrito.
Trustees are like our watchdogs to look out for our schools and students. They are, by definition, accessible to the public and accountable for the performance of our schools. They make decisions about school programs and staff. They decide how to spend our tax dollars to ensure that students get the best education for our money.
Los miembros de la mesa directiva son como perros guardianes que velan nuestras escuelas y estudiantes. Ellos, por definición, son accesibles al público y responsables por el rendimiento de nuestras escuelas. Ellos toman decisiones sobre los programas de las escuelas y el personal. Ellos deciden cómo gastar nuestro dinero de impuestos para así asegurar que nuestros estudiantes tengan la mejor educación por nuestro dinero.
For our forum today, candidates will introduce themselves in 1 minute or less and be asked 3 questions prepared by members of the Latino Parent Coalition before taking questions submitted by the public.
Para nuestro foro de hoy, los candidatos se presentarán en 1 minuto o menos y se les hará 3 preguntas preparadas por miembros de la coalición de padres latinos antes de responder a preguntas de la audiencia.
Audience members, you should write each question on an index card and hand it to our volunteers. Please, volunteers, raise your hand.
Se les pide a la audiencia que escriban sus preguntas en una tarjeta blanca y se les entregue a los voluntarios que han alzado sus manos.
Questions need to be addressed to all the candidates, not to a specific one.
Las preguntas deberán ser dirigidas a todos los candidatos, no a una persona en específico.
Candidates will have 90 seconds to answer each question. Our timekeepers, raise your hands, Frank. We'll warn the candidates with the yellow sign when 50 seconds remains, and with the red sign when their time is up. Candidates will have 2 minutes for closing statement.
Los candidatos tendrán 90 segundos. Nuestras personas encargadas de mantener el orden de tiempo será Frank y Ken. Favor de alzar sus manos con sus letreros. Y les avisarán a los candidatos con un letrero amarillo cuando queden 15 segundos y con un letrero rojo cuando se haya terminado el tiempo. Los candidatos tendrán 2 minutos para su declaración final.
The seating order for the candidates was decided by drawing numbers.
El orden de asientos fue decidido al escoger números.
We will begin with Kathy. You have 1 minute to introduce yourself.
Okay. Empezaremos con Kathy.
Good evening. I have experience as a community volunteer, higher education administrator, a senior human resources professional, and a parent of 2 adult children. My daughter, Sophia Metzner, is currently doing a social work internship at Sassarini in El Verano. I also have a single subject teaching credential and experience as a substitute teacher in the Valley Schools. I earned a doctorate at California Institute of Intellectual Studies, known as CIIS, in East-West Psychology, and I have been president of a startup college. I worked as an ED at the Earthrise Retreat Center in Petaluma. I now am a manager of a postgraduate doctoral program in a certificate program at CIIS. In service to the community, I've done a lot of community work, served on the board of the Sonoma Charter School. I was a Cub Scout leader, a Girl Scout leader, a CASA volunteer. I've also been a Peace Corps volunteer in Ecuador, where I was for 2 years.
Thank you, Kathy.
Mi nombre es Kathy y tengo experiencia tanto en la educación, higher education, que es ya pasado de la preparatoria, ¿verdad? Tengo experiencia en lo que es trabajo social y tengo un single subject que es maestra de una materia especial. So, tiene experiencia como maestra y en psicología también. Ha sido presidente de algunas instituciones. También, ahorita actualmente, trabajo como manager. Can you explain what CIS is?
California Institute of Integral Studies.
Okay. Es manager, gerente en el, es un instituto de estudios integrales y también ha sido miembro de la mesa directiva de Sonoma Charter School y así ha participado también en Girl Scouts. Thank you. Gracias.
Please pass a microphone.
Hello, my name's Omar Paz, Jr. I'm a Sonoma Valley native. I grew up here and went to Flowery Elementary, Alboran Elementary, Altamira Middle School, and Sonoma Valley High, and graduated in 2011. I am 25 years old. I've been in the Valley my whole life. Graduated from Santa Rosa Junior College, and recently came back from University of California at Santa Cruz, graduating Latin American Latino Studies and Sociology. I am the Immigration Efforts Coordinator at La Luz Center here in Sonoma Valley. I was a member of the Board of Trustees at Santa Rosa Junior College as a student trustee. I was president of the Student Senate for California Community Colleges, which represents 2.1 million students in the state of California in the community college system. I'm running because I really want to take this experience I've had as a student leader, as a student who's been uplifted by teachers and education my whole life, and to bring that passion to our valley and to really help make our schools best for students like myself.
Thank you.
We will give Omar another minute because he will be translating his own speech in Spanish. Le vamos a dar un minuto más a Omar porque va a estar haciéndolo en español él propiamente.
Buenas tardes. Me llamo Omar Paz y soy residente del Valle de Sonoma. Crecí aquí, fui a las escuelas de Flowery, de El Verano, Altamira y la secundaria de Sonoma. Gradué de la Colegio Comunitario de Santa Rosa y apenas llegué desde la Universidad de California Santa Cruz. Gradué con un gradué con estudios latinos y sociología. Ahorita trabajo en la Luz Center como coordinador de programas de inmigración. Fue miembro de la mesa directiva de, del Colegio Comunitario de Santa Rosa cuando estuve estudiante y también fue presidente del Senado del Estado representando 2.1 millones de estudiantes del sistema de colegios comunitarios en el Estado de California. Estoy aquí para representar el voz de los jóvenes y de representar mis responsabilidades como líder y joven de la comunidad y atraer mi experiencia a este valle y para ayudar a los niños de las escuelas que son como yo.
Gracias. Please, Melanie.
Good evening. My name is Melanie Blake. I've lived in Sonoma Valley for over 30 years. I raised my family here. My daughter went to Flowery Elementary School, Altamira, and the high school, as well as the JC before moving on to UC Davis. My background is over 35 years in public education, most of it spent here in Sonoma Valley. I'm most proud of having been a teacher in special education, in general education, working with ELL students and in alternative education. I also served as the principal of Dunbar Elementary School and worked with many families and students there. The fundamental issues for me as a trustee will include school safety, student achievement, fiscal responsibility. Thank you for being here. My main job is to serve your children and represent your interests. I look forward to working with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Please.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es Melanie Blake y tengo más de 30 años viviendo en el Valle de Sonoma. Aquí crecieron mis hijos. Mi hija fue a la escuela Ferry, Altamira, a la preparatoria, al JC, antes de transferirse a UC Davis. Y tengo más de 35 años de experiencia en la educación pública aquí en el Valle de Sonoma, tanto como en educación especial como trabajando con estudiantes que hablan inglés como segundo idioma. Fui directora de Dunbar y fundamentalmente lo que quiero decir es que para mí lo que importa es la seguridad de los niños, que haya un rendimiento bueno para los niños del distrito y que haya una responsabilidad fiscal. Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you. Please pass the microphone to Omar Paz Jr. for the first question. Let's welcome parents from the Latino Parent Coalition to ask the questions. Parents from Albarana and Flowery areas, Flor and Alex, will ask the first question.
Demos la bienvenida a los padres del área de El Verano y de Flory, Flory Alex, para que hagan la primera pregunta.
Gracias. Hola a todos, buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Alejandro Aguilar, pertenezco al grupo que acaban de nombrar las compañeras. Tengo niños en el colegio de Santa Rosa, en la preparatoria aquí de Sonoma y en Altamira. Pregunta. El distrito ha reducido el déficit de 9 millones a 3.5 millones de dólares al incrementar los tamaños de clase y reduciendo personal. Pregunta. ¿Cuál es su postura sobre el déficit del presupuesto actual? Flor, please, por favor.
Hi, my name is Flor, and I'm a president of one of the parent committees at El Verano School, and also a parent of a second grader, where they now have 25 students in her class. The question is, the district reduced the deficit from $9 million to $3.5 million by increasing class size and reducing staff. What will you do to address the current budget deficit? Thank you.
One of my platform issues happens to be budget transparency and budget accountability. My background is not in finance, however, that is something that a Board of Trustees member has to deal with for their term, and it's something they're responsible for as stewards of the community. So I think that one of the things that we should be ensuring and supporting is that the district has been making huge efforts to make those budgets more transparent and to address those issues. We have a new administration, we have a new superintendent who are working to address these issues, and us as board members are here to support them, to continue their work, but also to bring new ideas in. So to your point about what I would do specifically, I grew up in those large class sizes. I know what it's like as a student to experience an overcrowded classroom. It did affect my learning. I also have a learning disability, ADHD and ADD. So when it comes to money and investing, I think that's something that is made clear by parents and me as felt really deeply as a student. I want to make sure that us as a district and even as a state, whatever we can do to bring more funding to our schools, to our educators, and to our students ultimately is anything that we can do to that effort to support. And that involves making public and private partnerships. That includes working with our nonprofits in the Valley. That means working with parents who are already in the classrooms and putting in extraordinary amounts of time.
Thank you.
To help our students. Thank you.
Respuesta de Omar Paz. Bueno, en mi plataforma no tengo experiencia en las finanzas, pero sé que como parte de ser miembro de la mesa directiva es nuestra responsabilidad asegurar que haya todo el esfuerzo para que esto pueda suceder. Sé que ya hay administración nueva, igual que superintendente nuevo. Nosotros como la mesa directiva estamos aquí para apoyar, pero también traer nuevas ideas. En mi opinión, y yo sé lo que es haber estado en clases donde habían más niños, además de que también tengo una ADHD o ADHD, entonces mi opinión es de que tenemos que trabajar juntos para poder obtener más dinero para los maestros, los estudiantes y así también poder trabajar más con las organizaciones no lucrativas y con los padres que ya están apoyando las escuelas. Gracias. Thank you. Please pass the microphone to Melanie. Por favor, pasar el micrófono a Melanie.
So the question is about school budgets, and we recently went through a very painful process to cut staff from our schools in order to attempt to balance our budget. What would I do to address current budget deficit? We need to have a long-term plan. We need to look at state funding. State funding changes from year to year, but there are ways to anticipate that funding. We need to look at our LCAP. We need to talk about our district priorities and trends so that we know we can anticipate budget shortfalls and we know ahead of time which things we think we need to keep and which things we feel like we can let go of. We need to have structures in place to be able to anticipate when we have budget surpluses as well as budget deficits so that we have a plan in place how we're going to use our surplus and how we can manage those deficits. There's a saying that we want to keep the money as close to the kids as we possibly can, and that would be the lens that I bring to the board in order to ensure that the resources we have are being well spent in favor of student success.
Thank you.
Thank you. respuesta de Melanie Blank. Sé que, bueno, esta pregunta se refiere a los presupuestos. Hemos pasado por un proceso muy doloroso al perder varios personal para poder mantener el balance de nuestro presupuesto, ¿verdad? ¿Y qué es lo que haría yo? Ante todo, sería un plan a largo término, ¿verdad? Sabemos que el Estado tiene fondos, pero tenemos que saber cómo anticipar los patrones y ver cuándo van a suceder las cosas. Tenemos que saber cuáles son nuestras prioridades y ver qué es lo que más nos importa cuando tenemos que hacer recortes. También tenemos que ver cuando hay más dinero, qué se puede hacer para invertir ese dinero. Y poder ser más conservativos en eso. Y lo último que quiero decir es de que hay un dicho que dice que hay que mantener el dinero cerca de los niños para poder asegurar que ellos puedan tener éxito. Thank you. Gracias.
You may start, Kathy.
Okay. Well, regarding budgets, so the first thing I think is to deeply understand a budget. I'm sure the Sonoma School Board budget is complex, it's vast, there's so many competing needs, and I think that you can only make good decisions when you deeply understand something. So that would be my first job or challenge to, you know, deeply understand it as well as I can, and to also know that your knowledge increases over time. So it's deeply understanding the budgets, it's talking with people, it's considering all the competing needs. Certainly, class size is a huge one. My daughter came home today and said, you know, class size is such an issue from her experience. And it would be right up there, but everything has to be considered with everything else. I do have pretty vast experience with budgets. I've been a senior manager in higher ed and other jobs for about 30 years, and I've pretty much worked on the budgets in those organizations every year. And so it's tracking, knowing, all that.
Thanks.
La respuesta de Kathy. Antes que nada, pues lo importante es poder entender cómo se maneja un presupuesto. Los presupuestos son complejos y es muy importante entender que hay varias necesidades. Para hacer una buena decisión deberemos tener un entendimiento profundo, ¿verdad? Un conocimiento que se puede obtener al hablar con personas. Y ver cuáles son las necesidades de nuestra comunidad. Por ejemplo, obviamente, pues el tamaño de clase es algo importante. Incluso hoy mi hija vino a casa y se refirió a lo difícil que es estar en una clase donde hay bastantes niños. En mi caso, pues tengo amplia experiencia, más de 30 años en educación superior, y tengo experiencia haciendo presupuestos, y lo más importante es poder ver exactamente cuánto se está gastando para poder tomar decisiones mejores. Thank you. Gracias.
So for the next questions, please pass the microphone to Melanie Blake. And Gianni will ask this question. Please, let's welcome her.
Le damos la bienvenida a Janet para la segunda pregunta.
Buenas noches, mi nombre es Janet López y soy madre de familia de un estudiante de Flowery y dos estudiantes de la high school. Datos recientes muestran que la mayoría de los estudiantes en California son latinos. En el distrito, con poco éxito, han intentado mejorar el rendimiento de lectura y matemáticas. ¿Qué haría diferente? Recent data shows that the majority of the students in California are Latinos. The district has been trying with little success to improve students regarding math and performance. What would you do differently?
Our district is facing demographic changes as well as economic changes. One of the things that I'd like to speak with board members about is a demographic study for our community, which would help us to see the trends and where our neighborhood schools are headed. In addition to that, in looking directly at our curriculum, I know that our district has worked very hard to bring in common core standards, and that the students are having a difficult time meeting those standards. Some students struggle more than others. Certainly, we have subgroups of students when we look at our performance data in special education and our second language learners. And we also want to be sure that we're reaching our high-end kids and getting them ready for university and their next steps post high school. So I would want to be able to work with our managers, talk with our parents, see what's happening, talk to the administrators at our sites. I know that there are several terrific initiatives underway in our schools. As a school board trustee It's not my job to micromanage, but it is my job to look at the trends and to be working with the community and the management staff to ensure that we're reaching every single child in our district.
Thank you. Please pass the microphone too.
Bueno, respuesta de Melanie. Nuestro distrito, ¿verdad?, ha tenido muchos cambios en términos demográficos y económicos. Lo primero que yo recomendaría fuera que se hiciera un estudio demográfico para ayudar a vernos a dónde es que va cada escuela. Entiendo que en términos del currículo se ha usado el Common Core y que ha sido difícil para algunos estudiantes, especialmente los que están en educación especial y que hablan inglés como segundo idioma. Pero a la misma vez también entiendo que es importante tener un camino para los estudiantes que quieran asistir a la universidad. Para mí es importante hablar con la administración, con los managers o gerentes de los departamentos. Y sé que hay iniciativas, ¿verdad?, que están intentando hacer estos cambios. No es mi trabajo micromanejar al personal, pero sí estoy aquí para apoyar y ver cómo podemos trabajar.
Please, Omar.
Before I answer, could I just ask for the last sentence of the question to be repeated? I just misheard like two words. If it was math and curriculum?
Yeah, math and reading.
Okay,
reading.
Yes, reading.
Math.
Thank you. So as a board member of the Board of Trustees and as a candidate right now, a lot of this data does exist. In the LCAP, which was mentioned, the local control assessments, and the Sonoma Valley Community Profile, which has data up to 2016, where it shows that over 58% of the students in our school system of over 4,600 students are Latino. And at the same time, over 58% of them are on free and reduced lunch. I was one of those students. I wouldn't have been able to do sports to achieve a lot of what I did in school if it hadn't been for those programs. And when it comes to academic success, really the key thing that kept me from falling through the cracks was my teachers. And when it comes to curriculum and math achievement, I was fortunate enough to have the support of teachers who put in extra time beyond what they were required to help me achieve and move beyond. But I also saw my peers who were not given those same opportunities. I was lucky enough to have a majority of my teachers be people who inspired me to be where I am today. And when it comes to curriculum and math changes that I would ask, part of that is making sure that curriculum and math reflects the community and the changing demographic that includes the teachers, and helping them to be sensitive to the cultural responsiveness and learning styles of their students.
Thank you.
It's okay. Bueno, respuesta de Omar. Como posible miembro de la mesa directiva y ahora como candidato, ¿verdad? Yo sé que existe varias de estos datos. E incluso he visto el perfil del Distrito Escolar de Sonoma del 2016, donde hemos visto que más del 58% son latinos, esto representándose con un número de 4,600 estudiantes, y más del 58% también en estudiantes con almuerzo reducido. Esto en particular es algo que a mí me ayudó poder participar en deportes. También algo que me ayudó mucho fue, y lo que agradezco mucho, fue a las maestras que tomaron un paso más adelante siempre para poder ser mentores en mi vida y ayudarme a que yo pudiera tener éxito. Pero también vi estudiantes que no tenían este apoyo. Entonces, creo que es muy importante poder ayudar a los maestros para que culturalmente tengan el entrenamiento para que podamos enfrentar este, para mejorar el rendimiento de matemáticas y lectura.
So, you may begin, Kathy.
Well, with this issue, like many others, I have a learning curve. And so first is to just learn about what the issues are, what has worked in the past, what hasn't worked, evaluating, assessing, et cetera. I'm a pretty out-of-the-box thinker. And when I'm challenged with an issue or a problem, my mind just goes at it. And one example of this is when my son was at the Sonoma Charter School years ago. He did the very challenging exiting project at the end of the year, and I realized at the end, I thought, wow, he had parental help with this, but a lot of kids don't. And so I wanted there to be equal opportunity there, and I organized the whole charter school community to step up as mentors and to all the kids doing exiting projects, and I paired mentors with each eighth grader doing a project. So it's just an example. It's a small subset, but it's an example of how I go at something and really care about students of all in all situations, and I feel pretty confident that I could lean into assessments and some new resolutions.
Thank you.
En términos de este asunto, ¿verdad? Pues sí, no tengo mucha experiencia, pero siempre es muy importante aprender y me considero una pensadora que piensa fuera de la caja o más allá. Siempre me gusta pensar en qué otras alternativas hay. Ejemplo, cuando mi hijo participó en el proyecto que tienen que hacer para graduarse de charter, él tuvo mucho apoyo, ¿verdad? Y pues sí, observé cómo otros niños no tenían el apoyo. Fue allí donde se me ocurrió un proyecto donde hubiera más equidad y crear un proyecto de mentores donde cada niño tuviera un mentor. A mí me importa, ¿verdad?, que cada niño tenga esa equidad y pues siento que tengo con confianza decir que creo que es algo que yo podría apoyar.
So, Jero and Pablo will ask the next question.
Okay. Ahora pasará Jero y Pablo para hacer la próxima pregunta. Gracias. Thank you.
Hola, muy buenas tardes a todos. Mi nombre es Jero y mi pregunta es: recientemente, miembros de la mesa directiva escolar han sido acusados de micromanejar o de no involucrarse suficiente. En su opinión, ¿cuál es el rol de la mesa directiva escolar?
Hi, good evening. My name is Pablo Romo, and I got two kids on Barona School. I got a boy in second grade and a girl in fifth grade. And my question is, recently, trustees has been accused of micromanaging or not being involved. In your opinion, what is the role of the school board? Thank you.
Thank you, Jero and Pablo. Gracias, Jero y Pablo.
So, Omar, you may begin for that question. Oh, it's your turn. Okay. Okay, I will.
Do you have it?
Where is it? Okay. Recently, trustees have been accused of micromanaging or of not being involved. In your opinion, what is the role of school board?
Well, first of all, it's to be present and to attend every meeting of the school board and to read the documents beforehand and know what's you know what's before you and give it the time, and also to participate in the community, to meet people, to listen to people, attend special committee meetings if that's what's up. But the first thing is really to be present and informed. And secondly, it is to know the role and to not micromanage. I mean, I have a busy life, many people do, and I don't need to add micromanaging to the list. So and you have to trust people. I mean, and I understand the role of the school board really is to, it's the agenda before you and that's set by the superintendent. And so it's to work closely with the superintendent in terms of what the issues are with the, you know, with the school. And there's plenty of things that on the agenda and that need to be done without looking for other things. So I have lots of experience on, you know, boards and with senior management, and so, yeah, I think I pretty well understand the role of participation and not micromanaging.
Thank you.
Okay. Respuesta de Kathy. Bueno, antes que nada, lo más importante es estar presente. Asistir a las reuniones, leer los documentos antes y darle tiempo a la participación, reunirse con personas, escucharlos y de nuevo reitero, asistir y estar presente, además de estar informados. Es importante entender mi rol y con eso conlleva el saber de no micromanejar, tener la confianza personal y entender que la superintendente es la que maneja la agenda y trabajar con la superintendente. Hay muchas otras cosas que se puede estar haciendo en vez de estar micromanejando y pues eso para mí es lo más importante en cómo entiendo el rol de la mesa directiva.
Now you may begin, Omar.
So for me, the role of a trustee is, I agree with candidate Coleman, in that our role is to be present in the community and in the meetings, and I mean fully present, and not present over teachers' shoulders, not present over the superintendent's shoulders. They're the experts, the faculty, the superintendents, the district administrators have all been thoroughly trained to do their jobs. Our role is to bring community values to the forefront and to really help the public voice shine in these conversations. It's to really exemplify the values that our community drives and really wants seen in the classroom. You know, and that means being present and a conduit of the community's heart and their mind. And that translates to being fully present, reading the agendas thoroughly, as Planet Coleman mentioned. It means going above and beyond to extend a hand to the community and find those voices and the parents, the students, who can be leaned on for their experiences to know what direction we should be heading in. Who are we failing and why are they not at the table? Those are some really key questions that I think I've experienced as a student trustee at Santa Rosa Junior College. I was a student trustee member with no vote, so I know the importance of vote makes and an importance of what having a voice that is traditionally excluded present at the table can do to change the whole way a district operates.
Respuesta de Omar. Primordialmente, también es estar presente en la comunidad y en las reuniones y estar presente enteramente. No estar sobre los hombros de la administración, puesto que la administración ha sido entrenada y sabe lo que están haciendo. Lo importante es trabajar con el público y ser un conducto de ese público. Siempre trabajar más allá y trabajar con padres y estudiantes también.
y cuando algo falla, saber por qué está fallando y tratar de hacer algo por eso. Y eso es mi opinión.
Melanie.
I think for myself, being part of a school board is a combination of kind of what the rules say and what my experience says. When I was asked to run for school board by my neighbors, my friends, my colleagues, they told me they wanted someone who is visible. Someone who can help to bring experience to the conversation. Someone who knows what it's like to be in the classroom every day. So as a trustee, I see my role as a dance between the community and the schools. How do we translate the concerns, the interests, the values of our community into policies and practices that we can see on our campuses and for our students every day? I do need to be prepared. I do need to be present. I do need to be visible. I need to be collaborative. I need to know how to create with the community through LCAP, through committees, through student activities, and by being a presence in the schools. Hopefully, I can represent you on our school board.
Thank you.
Creo que para mí es una combinación de las reglas de la, de la mesa directiva y mi experiencia. Cuando me hicieron esta, cuando me pidieron ser parte de la mesa directiva, por mis vecinos, por mis familiares, por mis colegas, me dijeron, ¿sabes? Necesitamos alguien que sea visible, que tenga experiencia, que pueda apoyar a la conversación, alguien que haya estado en las aulas. Creo yo que esto es como un baile entre la comunidad y las escuelas, que los valores se puedan traducir a políticas y prácticas para nuestros estudiantes. Yo, para mí, es de que yo necesito estar presente, necesito estar informada, necesito colaborar, tengo experiencia en diferentes comités, necesito participar en comités, en las escuelas y en actividades de los estudiantes, al igual.
Do we have other questions?
Jerón Pablo, ¿tienen preguntas? ¿Alguien ha recogido preguntas de la audiencia? ¿Pueden traerlas?
Okay. So, oh my God. So please pass the microphone back to Omar for questions that are being submitted by email on cards tonight. If there are several questions on the same topic, we will combine them into one question. You have 90 seconds for each response.
Muy bien. Bueno, ahora hemos recibido estas tarjetas, ya sea electrónicamente o en las tarjetas. Y vamos a darles 90 segundos para responder a las preguntas. Si son de un mismo tema, vamos a combinarlas. Okay. Bueno, creo que we're gonna just choose... because there are many. Can somebody let me know what the time is on the actual form? What are... Okay, thank you. So the question is what information do you have about El Verano and Flowery areas? that you are planning to that you're planning to running to present. What does this tell you about changes that need to occur? Omar?
Do you mind repeating just the first part of the sentence?
Yeah. It says, what information do you have about El Verano and Flowery areas where you are planning to present? What does this tell you about the changes that need to occur at the schools?
La pregunta es, ¿qué información tienes, tienen, perdón, sobre el área del verano y Flowery? ¿Y qué les dice esto en términos de lo que tiene que cambiar?
So my experience comes from being a student of this district. I attended both Flowery and El Verano, not in the dual immersion program at Flowery, but I was there from K through second grade, and then from third grade to fifth grade is at El Verano. So my experience is a lived one from the years of 2000 to 2005. And my experience was mostly positive, but again, I have to defer to kind of something that I noticed in both schools, and that was the failure of some students and the success of others. You know, whether I succeeded because it was my skin color, because of the way I talked, or a myriad of other reasons, you know, that'll be, you know, an unanswered question. But what stuck with me the most was the failure of those who did not look like me, however, who were still my peers and my community members, my fellow classmates. That isn't to say that, you know, there was prevalent discrimination in the schools. It's something that I think it goes unspoken in communities, not just in California, but across the nation, where the changing demographics of Latino students specifically, however, a variety of other demographics, you know, is something that the schools really need to adapt to responding to. And we need the resources to do that. Teachers are willing and ready to put in the extra effort to address these issues. However, we need to be there as a community member and board members to continue supporting.
Thank you.
La respuesta de Omar, él asistió tanto a Flowery como a El Verano de los años 2000 a 2005, de kinder a segundo en Flowery y tercero a quinto en El Verano. Para él tuvo una experiencia positiva, pero esto no quiere decir pues que él no vio que había estudiantes que no tuvieron el éxito que él tuvo. Y no sabe si fue por el color de su piel, por cómo él hablaba, y no puede decir que había discriminación, pero sí sabe que esto es algo que está sucediendo en todos los Estados Unidos con los cambios de la demográficos, y es importante que las escuelas puedan adaptarse a ese cambio y ver cómo pueden trabajar con los maestros para ayudar a esos estudiantes.
So you may begin, Kathy.
I've lived in the El Verano area for 28 years, as long as I've lived in Sonoma Valley. And my son went to school at El Verano and had actually had a very positive experience, good teachers. I think that El Verano's strength is in community. It was back then, and it still is today in terms of what I see. I think the biggest challenges are lots of English language learners, resources, crowded classrooms, which are prevalent everywhere, which is a problem everywhere. Those are kind of the main things, but you know, there's a lot of strengths there too. So to meet those challenges.
Thank you.
En respuesta de Kathy, pues tengo más de 28 años aquí en el área de Sonoma. Mi hijo fue a la escuela al verano y puedo decir que su experiencia fue buena, tuvo buenos maestros. Y creo que uno de las fortalezas de la escuela al verano es la comunidad. Claro que hay retos, ¿verdad? Si hablas inglés como segundo idioma, los recursos y obviamente el tamaño de las clases, que es uno de los problemas principales.
Maybe again.
So, what changes do I think need to occur? I know that in the El Verano area and the Flowery area, it's hard to buy a home. It's hard to rent a home. This is not an easy place economically to live. We need in our schools to be able to support our students and our families in helping them to succeed here in Sonoma Valley. We need to help teachers get more resources into the schools, into the classrooms, into the hands of our children. Our parents know our students best, and we know education. I'm not sure what specific changes we need at our two schools. I know with dual immersion at Flowery and the community school happening at El Verano, there are wonderful programs in place now. What can we do to make it better? I need to listen first to my constituents and the educators and determine how best to continue to move our schools forward and improve student achievement.
Thanks.
Respuesta de Melanie. En términos de qué es el cambio que se necesita para poder el cambio que se necesita para la escuela al verano, ¿verdad? Es difícil. Sabemos que es difícil comprar una casa, mucho menos rentar. Y no es fácil vivir en un lugar donde donde no hay apoyo. Necesitamos que las escuelas funcionen como apoyo para los estudiantes, que ayuden a los maestros, que puedan traer recursos tanto para la escuela como para los estudiantes y que ese dinero pueda llegar a la mano de los niños. Los padres son nuestros mejores aliados. Y también sé que hay muchos programas que están ahorita apoyando, como el programa de doble inmersión en Flowery y el programa de las escuelas comunitarias en el verano. Y pues lo primero que tengo que hacer es yo poder escuchar a la comunidad y ver cómo podemos trabajar juntos.
So please pass the microphone. And we will ask one more question. As a school board trustee, what do you see as challenges in our district regarding equity? Would you support and be willing to lead efforts for implicit bias training for all staff? Lastly, do you see areas of inequity regarding to low proficiency scores in our district? What both would you like to see the LCAP play to improve proficiency?
Y la pregunta es la siguiente. Dice, como miembro de la mesa directiva, ¿cuáles son los retos que usted ve en términos de la equidad? ¿Apoyarían ustedes que hubiera un entrenamiento para el personal de las escuelas? Y por último, ¿ven ustedes áreas de inequidad en términos de los resultados en nuestro distrito? ¿Y cuál es el rol que ustedes ven el comité LCAP jugar en mejorar el rendimiento?
Can you please repeat the question one more time?
I think it's one question, but I'll go ahead and read, okay? So it says, as a school board trustee, what do you see as challenges in our district regarding equity? Would you support and be willing to lead efforts for implicit bias training for all staff?
Lastly, do you see inequity regarding the low proficiency scores in our district? And what role would you like to see the LCAP play to improve proficiency?
Thank you. So, challenges regarding equity. I'm working right now at Sonoma State on a project called the Global Education Project. It's part of the 9 subject matter materials that the state of California focuses on each year. I see our students needing to become global citizens. And so, yes, we have a big challenge in our community with the issue of equity. And for me, equity is not what's equal. It's making sure that every single student that walks through our door is given the opportunity to succeed and the support that they need to succeed. A wonderful student in this valley uses something called toolkits in her classroom. And when one child gets one thing and another child gets another, she explains to the children, well, that's the tool that they need. And so we need to work on that. I'm not familiar with implicit bias training, but I am familiar with a lot of equity training that's going on around the state. I'd be happy to support that. And I think that in terms of equity and low proficiency, yes, when we look at our data and we look at our sub-test scores, we need to do more work
Thanks.
There.
Respuesta de Melanie, en términos de los retos en equidad. Trabajo en la Universidad de Sonoma en un proyecto que se llama Global Education Project, Educación Global, el proyecto de Educación Global. Y creo que si yo sé que es importante y veo a los estudiantes que deben de ser ciudadanos del mundo. Sé que para tener equidad no tenemos que darles todo a los estudiantes o lo mismo a todos los estudiantes, sino que tenemos que ver qué es lo que ese estudiante, cada estudiante necesita para ser exitoso. Tengo una colega que usa algo que se llama un toolkit, que es una caja de herramientas, y allí ellos pueden poner cuáles son las herramientas que ellos necesitan, ¿verdad? Y no tengo experiencia con entrenamientos implícitos, pero sí tengo experiencia en entrenamientos de equidad.
Soma.
When it comes to equity, I do think we have a long way to go as a district and as a community. My experience with this, again, is lived. I saw those students who fell through the cracks, and I could have been one of them easily. I think that we have a long way to go in making sure that all educators are on the same page of what the students need based on their demographic. Special needs students have different needs than Latino students. Students from queer or non-gender conforming backgrounds also have different needs. However, a lot of these identities intersect, and that's where it gets really complicated, is we need to be able to address these issues from an approach that acknowledges the differences, but also the strengths of these identities and these backgrounds. When it comes to implicit bias training, yes, I fully support that. My experience comes directly from having been trained, received training and information on it, and then having to have experienced information on it from the Community and Local Law Enforcement Task Force. My perspective comes from more of using this training for police officers in their treatment of non-white community members, and that extends to school resource officers, which are on our campuses and have to work to, you know, in that area as well. So the same goes for our teachers. We need to have those resources available to them so that they are able to, you know, bridge the gaps between their backgrounds and their students.
Respuesta de Omar.
Sí creo que todavía nuestras escuelas tienen mucho trabajo que hacer en términos de equidad, y esto lo puedo decir por mi experiencia que viví en las escuelas de Sonoma. Hubieron niños que yo sé que fueron fallados, que no tuvieron el éxito, y yo pude haber sido uno de ellos. Tenemos los diferentes estudiantes, ya sea si son de educación especial, si son latinos o si son de la comunidad LGBTQ. Pero hay diferentes grupos de estudiantes, pero necesitamos tener una manera de poder trabajar con todos estos retos. Y sí creo que el entrenamiento implícito debería de ser algo que debería de hacerse en las escuelas. He tenido yo experiencia sobre esos entrenamientos, pero más en términos de cómo las autoridades trabajan con estudiantes, por ejemplo, los oficiales que están en las escuelas. Y pues creo que aún tenemos mucho que hacer.
Well, there are certainly equity issues in our community, as there are in many places in the world. But right before us, of course, there's the Prestwood District is very different from El Romano and Flowery, for example. And I know that El Romano school, the principal has to do a lot of fundraising. And I don't know if that's fair, or I don't know if that can be done in some other way. I feel like I would have to get to know the budget and the issues. It seems rather unfair. It seems like there might be some other way to do it, but I don't know for sure. Implicit bias training. Some of these things, I mean, I've been in higher ed for 30 years, so even though it's somewhat different, there's a lot of issues that are similar and transfer over to high school, grade school, community education. So I guess it's just something that equity is always an issue, and to work on it. And my example about the charter school, the project I took on, it's like thinking out of the box and trying to address it in numerous different ways.
Okay, gracias. Ahora la respuesta de Kathy. Bueno, pues sí, hay muchos buenos asuntos en términos de este tema de la equidad aquí localmente como en el mundo. Obviamente, por ejemplo, Prestwood es muy diferente a la escuela El Verano y Flowery. Sé que la escuela El Verano tiene que hacer mucha recaudación de fondos, y la verdad no creo que se vale y que no es justo. Creo que debería de haber diferentes maneras en que también pudieran ellos obtener recursos. Y he tenido experiencia con entrenamientos de equidad, que creo que puedo relacionar en términos de la escuela.
So we have to stop the questions now. Please remember that you can ask the candidates more questions after we end.
Bueno, ahora tenemos que poner alto a las preguntas. Recuerden que pueden ustedes hacerle preguntas a los candidatos después de que termine el foro.
We will now hear closing statements in the reverse order of introductions. Each candidate has 2 minutes.
Ahora vamos a escuchar a las declaraciones finales, y esto va a ser en la orden de que se hicieron las presentaciones iniciales. Y vamos a empezar con Melanie. We'll start with Melanie. Yes.
So I find myself in the unique position of running unopposed for the flowery seat. And so I want to be able to thank you all in advance for the wonderful support that I had early on. In our schools today in Sonoma Valley, we do have many challenges. We can also see those challenges as wonderful opportunities. I've had the experience and the privilege of working on our high school campus, our middle school campuses, and our elementary campuses. I have loved my work with teachers, with staff, with families, and most of all, with the students. You're all here tonight giving this valuable time. I know how busy you all are. And here you are listening to us because your children matter. They matter more than anything in the world. And I share that value with you. And that's what's brought me to the decision to serve on our local school board. And I know that whether we're talking about elementary, middle school, or high school, whether we're talking about gifted and talented children, special needs children, second language learning children, they're all our children. And we have an opportunity here to make this the best district anywhere. We have the families, we have the resources, we have the community, and we have a chance to bring us all together. I'm really looking forward to working with you come December.
Thank you.
Bueno, pues creo que me encuentro en una posición pues muy especial porque no tengo contrincante, pero antes que nada quiero agradecer todo el apoyo que tengo y el que tuve desde antes. Creo que nuestras escuelas tenemos muchos retos, pero los veo como oportunidades de poder trabajar tanto con los padres, los maestros y los niños. He trabajado en la preparatoria, en la secundaria, en la primaria, y pues agradezco que ustedes estén aquí esta noche donde ustedes pudieran estar en algún otro lugar, pero para mí creo que es importante decirles que para ustedes los niños importan y para mí los niños importan, y creo que eso es algo que compartimos. Y no importa si son niños de educación especial, si hablan inglés como segundo idioma, todos los niños son importantes. Y creo que tenemos una oportunidad para hacer este el mejor distrito escolar y espero poder trabajar con ustedes en diciembre.
Omar.
I'm running as a local voice who has experienced a lot of the problems that have existed and still existed today. Why I ran is to give the opportunities to the future generations to experience something different, to experience something that is new and supportive of their experiences. I have two little sisters who will go to Flowery and they're in the first and third grades. I want to see them continue to be successful and continue to not have to fight as hard as I did to stay, you know, academically competent, to not have to fight as hard as a lot of students do because of their backgrounds, because of being low income, because of discrimination, because of things that are pervasive, not just in our schools, but in society as a whole. My experience as a student leader was only possible because of educators. My family supported me, but my teachers and my district staff showed me that there was potential within me as someone from a separated household who was low income, who went to food pantries, who considers themselves an ally of the marginalized. I also feel that I am well positioned to be a voice for those communities or to be a facilitator for the people who can speak directly, more directly to those experiences than I can. And that, I think, is most important. To this position and to this role as a community steward, as someone who doesn't just speak for the voices of the community, but has them speak for themselves and empowers them to participate in the process and builds the bridges so that they can do so effectively in a way that doesn't mean, you know, that isn't just beneficial for us as board members, but it's easy for them to accommodate. Voting for me will be voting for a youth voice, and for me, it's not about the title or position. Regardless of winning or not, I plan to do this work. So I thank you for your time and for being
here. Thank
you. Respuesta de Omar. Bueno, estoy aquí corriendo para este puesto, porque tengo la experiencia en las escuelas, pero lo que yo quiero hacer es poder ofrecerle una experiencia diferente a los estudiantes, una y nueva. Tengo dos hermanas en la primaria, una en primer grado, otra en tercer grado, y yo quiero que ellas puedan ser exitosas sin tener que luchar con los obstáculos de discriminación o por rendimiento escolar. Y esto no lo digo solamente por una comunidad, sino es algo que está pasando en toda nuestra sociedad. Mi éxito lo puedo atribuir a mis maestros que me apoyaron y a mis padres. Lo que sí puedo decir es que pude no haber tenido éxito, puesto de que venía de una familia separada, familia de bajos ingresos, donde sí tuve que asistir a las distribuciones de comida. Y como representante, no solamente voy a dar una voz a la comunidad, sino los quiero empoderar para que ellos sean su propia voz y que cuando vengan a las juntas pueda haber una manera accesible para que ellos puedan dar su voz durante las reuniones. Gracias.
Kathy, you may begin.
I'm running for school board out of a sense of service. I've had a pretty good life. I've well educated. I've had a long career. I'm kind of a born administrator, and I just feel like I want to continue to give back. I come from parents who, my father served on a school board for many years. My parents were very involved in the community, and I'm just a firm believer in community service, and especially kind of as a gratitude for what I have had in my life. If I'm elected, the personal qualities I bring is I'm very collaborative, I'm a good problem solver, I have a can-do attitude, I am upbeat, I have an enormous amount of energy, I'm kind of dogged and determined. If there's something even that can't be solved today, I'll continue to work on it. And I bring a lot to the table. At the same time, I feel like this district is pretty lucky. Omar is also a great candidate, and we've met several times, and I feel privileged to know that he's got a great mission as well and lots of skills. And we talked today about whether we win or lose, about being more engaged in the community and in the issues of the schools. So for me already, it's been a really worthy project to run for school board, and I feel like I'm way more interested and invested and knowledgeable about the issues, and I hope to serve you, but if I'm not elected, I'll still be serving you.
Thank you, Kathy.
Okay. Bueno, yo estoy corriendo por la mesa directiva por el sentido del servicio a la comunidad. He tenido una buena vida y esto se lo agradezco mucho a mi padre, que él también dio servicio a la comunidad. Y espero seguir haciendo eso. Si soy electa, puedo decir que soy una persona, ¿verdad?, que me gusta resolver los problemas, soy de buen ánimo y me gusta trabajar con la comunidad. También quisiera Sé que Omar también es un buen candidato y hemos platicado hoy, ¿verdad? De que perdamos o ganemos, vamos a seguir trabajando en la comunidad. Para mí, toda esta experiencia me ha vuelto mucho más interesada y también me importa más invertir tiempo en este distrito escolar. Thank you.
That concludes our candidates forum for Sonoma School District Trustees. Please stay to talk with the candidates and stop by the tables with information about the ballot measures. This forum has been filmed by KSBY TV.
Esto concluye el final de este foro. Les invitamos a que por favor platiquen con los candidatos después. Y este foro fue filmado por KSBY.
Thank you to all volunteers from the Latino Parent Coalition and the Sonoma Valley Housing Group.